Hey everybody, it's Annie Souter from Bay Club, and I'm here with another workout. I don't know if I would call it an interval workout necessarily, even though I might label it that, because we're only gonna really do one interval. The rest of it is gonna be by number of reps. So you and I might be at different places at different times, but that's okay. Pause me if you need to, fast forward me if you need to, but just stick with the number of reps that I'm giving you for this one, and it'll make more sense when we get started. You know, we just started back teaching at the club, and my classes are kind of clustered together, right? They're Friday, Saturday, and Monday, and they're all the same, right? Right now, all I'm teaching is the high fitness sort of aerobics class. And that is the same workout for me, right? It's a lot of jumping, it's a lot of cardio. And so it's kind of change what and when I need to do workouts at home. And depending on if your schedule changes like that, either with the club opening or whatever you're doing, you may need to adjust your workouts too. So for me, with the three sort of cardios and a lot of leg-focused jumping, I noticed immediately that my legs aren't very happy, like my things that get tight and painful have become tight and painful like with 1 week. So what I'm going to do today is try to balance out the workouts for me, right? So yes, this is sort of full body. I did try to take quad focus out of it just because that's what hurts on me right now is my quads. But I do have a little bit of hamstring and I do have a little bit of glute, but this is mostly an upper body workout. And that is to complement what I am doing at the club. Now, not every one of my workouts from here on out will be like that, but this week today, since I'm filming this on a Thursday, right, I'm going right into my little cluster. That's what it's gonna be today. So hopefully this is a workout that you can either use now or maybe sometime in the future when your legs are burned out too, just like mine are. So, and I'm talking quads for me because I'm very quad dominant. So yes, we're gonna do a little hamstring, we're gonna do a little glute mixed in with our upper body, but a lot of it's upper body focus. So that being said, here's what we're gonna use. I am gonna give you a lot of options because I am gonna use my red long band today. And these are pretty easy to get online if you like some of the exercises that I'm doing, but you don't have one. Traditionally, like you would maybe use these the most in the gym for assisting with pull-ups, right? So you loop it on whatever you're pulling up against, right? You put a foot in here, right? And it takes some of the weight off so that you can sort of go from not being able to do a push-up to a push-up. I do that a lot with when I used to personal train with clients. But you can do other things with them too. And I'm gonna show you some of the things. I'm gonna, for example, tie a knot on one end and I'm gonna close it in that door over there and use it for a couple things. And I'm also gonna use it with my barbell. Now, I know many of you may not have any of this stuff that I'm talking about. Don't worry. Everything that I'm doing, I have a dumbbell equivalent for you to do, and I will make sure to tell you all of it. So don't feel weird if you don't have this, but it might give you some ideas that if you wanted to get one of these, they're relatively cheap as far as gym equipment goes, and it might give you some more options at home for things to do, which is why I decided to do it today. Okay, so with that, I'm gonna use this for quite a few things, not a ton, but you know. I'm gonna use my barbell, but you can use dumbbells. I have my dumbbells out, you can barely see them right here. I'm gonna use my mini band, my hip circle, for one thing. I'm gonna use the chair for some tricep dips, so for one thing. And aside from that, I think it's just all dumbbells. So are we ready? That was a long intro. It was like a three, almost 4 minute intro. That was a lot. All right, I'm gonna turn on some music and we're gonna warm up. And then we'll get into it. So remember, today is not as many timer-based things. Today's gonna be a lot of rep-centric things, and most of our reps are gonna be in sets of 12. And 12 is a number that is on the higher end of a rep set, right? It's kind of designed for when you have lighter weights, which I think we probably all are more likely to have at home than something really heavy when you might take your rep count down to like 6 or 8 or something like that. So that's why we're doing 12s. Now, if you're in the middle of this and you're like, wow, 12 is really easy, you can always do more, right? Go up to 15 or go up to 20, depending on what you have. If you feel like what you have is too heavy to do 12 with, then cut it back, right? Cut it back to 6 or 8 or whatever. So you're gonna have to play with it because I don't know what you have, but you know what to do, right? You know what to do now, and I will give you lots of options. All right, ready, let's go. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna start with a little body weight warm up for the upper body. And I've heard this called YTI, right? But I don't think you do it in YTI order. So you're gonna, so if you went Y and then you went T and then you went I, it doesn't really make a lot of sense, right? Because you're like YMCAing this. Like, barely hear myself talk. All right, but we're going to TYI, all right? So you're gonna lean over, brace the core, and you're gonna reach out to a T, reach out to a, like a letter Y, and then straight up for a letter I. So I have my hands with like my pinky down toward the ground. So start that way if you can. And then we're gonna change the hand position, right? So I'm leaning over, right? And pushing here. And I really want you to pull those elbows in and squeeze at the bottom, right? Out to the sides. Do some more here. I can already feel it warming up my back. And it's just body weight. All right, let's change this palm position. Let's do our full palm down toward the ground. So here, in that Y position, that I position. There you go. Reach. All right. Shall we try some with a little thumbs down? That's probably feel a little inverted to you, but you can probably feel where it's going. Different places. All right, let's go 8 more counts. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. All right, come on over on the mat. Let's do some easy push-ups here. A little barbell. It's like a mini barbell. It's not like the size, you can tell. It's not the size of the gym, right? It's a short one. It only weighs 25 pounds. All right, some nice easy push-ups. I'm going to take my elbows out at a 45. And just take it easy. You're just warming up. Some of you will be doing this later, depending on what equipment you have. Some push-ups. Ooh, yeah. I am not warm today, I will tell you that. So I'm spreading my fingers out, pushing my full palm into the ground, getting my chest all the way down. Let's do a couple more. All right, push back. Next time you come in, let's push up, but instead of having your arms at a 45, right, tuck them in, and let's do some tricep push-ups. I'm actually stronger in my tricep push-up than I am in my regular push-ups. Same thing, get that chest down. One more, and then I'm going to switch to the other side. Same thing. Ooh, where'd that leg go? Up. Like I'm trying to hit the ceiling with my heel, right? My first one kind of went off and out to the side. Ugh. Isn't it amazing when you feel your glutes, and they're like, oh, they're like they're awakening, right, from a long hibernation. Yeah, at least I feel that way during this quarantine. Let's do a couple more this side.
Alright, I'm gonna go back to the other side. I'm gonna triple pulse at the top. So 3, 2, 1. Put a little weight in your hands. We're still kind of warming up the upper body here in this like little tabletop position. I'm gonna do one more of these triple pulses. I'm gonna go to the other side. 3 big squeezes at the top. Get all of that work in. I'm gonna do 2 more over here. All right. So from here, we're gonna practice some good mornings. If you don't have a band and barbell kind of combo, this is what you're gonna be doing while I do that, right? Or there's actually 2 choices, but this might be one of the things. I'm gonna take my lightest set of dumbbells here. And if you don't have a light set, go with your body weight, right? And I'm gonna lean over. So I'm spreading my legs. I like them wide, you know that. So I'm gonna put my legs a little more than hip distance apart. And I'm gonna fold over. I'm gonna stand up. That should be an entirely hamstring exercise. When I stand up, I'm gonna squeeze my glutes right there. Yep. So come down and come up and squeeze. So if I were doing it without dumbbells, right, I would put my hands up like in this prisoner position, right, and come down. You can actually add resistance that way by giving a gentle push, right? Not too hard on your head. And right here, up and squeeze. And even without dumbbells, I can definitely feel it on the backs of my legs. Let's go a few more. Slide that booty out. Flat back. A lot of times in class, I see this, right? Slide it out. 2 more, how about? All right, let's put these down. Actually, let's not put these down. Let's start with a little bicep curl here. We're going to just easy bicep curl. We are going to bicep curl in the workout today. I will probably use something heavier than this, but we'll see when we get there, right? So this is just a traditional bicep curl, right, with my palms facing forward. It's a little bit different if you turn this way and hammer curl. Changes where it hits on your bicep, so they're both good. I generally find this one easier, in which case I normally go with this one. Yeah. So all the way up, all the way down, right? The curl and then goes down to your thigh. Let's do one more each side. All right, let's tricep warm up here, right? So kick it back, bring it in. We're just trying to get everything primed and ready to go for this workout. Let's go one more set of this music, yeah? So I'm just bringing them right to my legs, right? Nothing up by the chest. One more. All right. So here's our one and only interval for today that actually has a timer. So I'm gonna do handstands over there. And what that focuses on is your entire upper body and also some core. But do you have to do a handstand? Absolutely not, right? Do a plank, right? Do a plank. Either forearm plank or hand plank. I would suggest forearm if you can. And weight yourself, right? So if you're in this plank, you can put something on your back, right? Whether it be a book, whether it be a weighted backpack, whatever it is that won't slide off. So if you need more difficulty, but you don't want to handstand with me, add some weight to your plank, because that's going to warm up the rest of what we need, the core, and then it's going to polish off our upper body here. And we're gonna do this in a traditional Tabata. So 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. So you'll come down and rest for 10 and then come right back at it. So whatever, if you're gonna plank,
whatever you have on your back needs to not slide off during that process, all right? Okay, so you think about what you want. I'm gonna take a sip of water. I'm gonna get my timer going. I'm gonna handstand over there, all right? And you go with what you wanna do today. Seems counterproductive to like put water down and then I'm gonna flip over, you know what I'm saying? All right, get my timer on, make sure it's loud enough. All right, 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest, 8 times through, and you know what? I've got a big shirt on today, so I'm gonna like tuck it all the way around. Good. All right, you ready? Let's go. That was really not graceful. All right, if you're in this handstand, squeeze your glutes, right? Push the floor away with your hands, engage your core. Can definitely feel it on the upper body immediately. All right, if you've got that plank going, just rest your hips down, right? Take some pressure off your upper body. All right, here it comes. Push the floor. If you're in that plank, sink your chest. I did buy a pull-up bar. Haven't installed it yet, but I bought it. All right, here we go. I feel it in my core for sure. Now when I feel like my hands are a little wide, that made it like extra hard. I'm gonna try to go more narrow. All right, three. Three more times, it's getting hard. Push. Hold that plank, tighten your core down there. Ooh, doggy. Search. You put them back down. Feel it everywhere up here. Okay, last one. Going. I like already rejoiced and drank water, so I don't want to like pop back up. All right, we ready for these rep sets? So they come in little groups of three, right? So for the first one, we're gonna work on shoulders. So we're gonna take the dumbbells for the first one and go around and around back, right? So it's just gonna be around and around. So probably a lighter set for that, for part one. Then we're gonna do some tempo up, right? And then we're gonna pull it down slow. So it's gonna be an overhead press. We're gonna push it up fast, pull it down slow. And the final thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna do these banded deadlifts, which I will show you how to set up this bar. But you, if you don't have the whole setup, are gonna be doing those good mornings from the warm-up. Unless those hurt your back or feel tweaky for whatever reason, in which case you're gonna do a normal sort of straight leg deadlift here that we've done many a time, right? So you'd hold two dumbbells, or if you have a bar, right? And then you bend over like this. It's the same move as the good morning, right? The same upper body type move. Your arms are just in a different position. I would say the good morning is more intense in a lot of ways, just because of that position, but you can certainly go heavier when you deadlift. So that's your option for when I get my bar and band on. But pay attention to that, because if you do end up setting up a gym at home, right, this might be a good one, a good tool and a good move for you to add in. All right, so shoulder this way, shoulder this way, and then some hamstrings, either with the dumbbells or whatever combination you have. So for setting this up, I take my long band and I put it underneath this bar on both sides, right? Like this. All right. And then what I'm gonna do is stand on it. And I did try this without shoes, but you know, shoes would probably be preferable. Stand on it, and then I'm gonna take this like this, right? And the band is adding the resistance because I don't have plates that I can't find anywhere to get them, right? So I'm gonna lean over with that same motion. I'm gonna come up and squeeze my glutes in the same way. And the band is the resistance on that. All right, so we're gonna do 12 of each. We're gonna go three times through. So 12, right? And on these, depending on your weight, you might count one rep as forward and back. You might count one rep as one, two, right? Because if you have something very heavy, that's gonna be a really hard exercise. All right, these 12 of each, three times through, and hopefully we'll end up ending at the same place just about. All right, here we go, you ready? All right, 12. So I'm gonna go this way. One. So I've got my lighter set here. Two. Three. So think about over the top of the shoulders and over the back, right? So five. Six. Seven. Down, because in between I just want you to rest a little bit because we're hitting the same muscle group two times in a row here, right? So these are going to be the tempo, fast up, slow down. Now depending on the weights, you can bring them all the way down, you can bring them to shoulder height to cut the length, right, of the movement. I would go all the way down if you can. All right, let's try big and see what happens. Bigger. All right, here we go. I will on this set, but I think next time I'm going lighter on this set. Got one more. All right, rest a little bit before you do your last one. Remember, now for you, it might be a good morning. Might be a deadlift with dumbbells. All right. If you somehow, some way have this set up, you're good to go. All right. During my rest. All
So like at our gym, right, our strength equipment is upstairs, right? So I call this an upstairs workout when you're doing reps, right? It's not like in class where you're constantly doing something, right? You think about a workout like this where there is time and space in between the activities, right? There's like waiting time for your muscles to recover because generally you're going heavier, right? We're kind of in a weird hybrid here. We probably have lighter weights, but we're doing the workout like it's a strength workout upstairs instead of a class workout. All right. Which is why I'm taking my time resting. Okay. I'm gonna do 12 of these. Good mornings, deadlifts, whatever you're gonna do. All right, here we go. All right, so my starting position is here. I've got that nice flat back, just like we're doing the warm-up. I'm squeezing my glutes. Remember, you're doing 12, yeah? Big glute squeeze at the top. Got one more here. All right. I'm gonna do the whole thing again. Round two. Two of three. All right, three times through. All right. Rest, water. Pretend like you're upstairs. Go talk to your friends for a second. Yep. All right. So, since we did the lower body, last thing, you might already be ready to start on the shoulders again. All right, we're ready? Here we go. All right. One. Three. Unlock those knees if you've got them locked, right? Maybe you can take a stagger stance if you need to. Presses. So the other little tri sets that we have, it's not double the work on a single body part. For example, we'll do chest and biceps together. We'll do back and triceps together. So this is the only one where we're doubling up on the shoulder work, but we're doing two different styles of exercises on it, right? Shoulders are important. All right. Ready? I'm gonna use these this time. Slow. Two. Uh-huh. Halfway in for me. Burny up here. See, like it just looks very, I don't know, sloppy? Try tucking it in. Okay. Alright, get my feet down on these, get it flat here. Alright, you ready to do yours? Do them at the same time, maybe? Right, spread my feet out a little bit. There we go. Alright, here we go. Start here. Pull. gonna go one more time through, then we're moving on. My heart rate's up, not like a 10 out of 10, but it's up from resting for sure. Something that would feel like a light cardio to me. Yep. All right. Got one more time through. Just kinda get yourself ready here. All right, should we get after it? Let's get done. All right. I have no guarantee though that I was actually 12. You know, when I personal trained, I realized that was like a big part of the job was counting reps for clients, but I'm terrible at counting reps. I can count to the music all day long. Counting reps, I just get like really distracted. I don't know. Think about other things. Yeah, it's dangerous. All right, let's do those overhead presses. Give you electricity, give it to you. Six for me, I think. Seven. Got one more for me. Broke. There we go. All right. It's a good feeling to have those end ones be challenging, like you're questioning how many more you can do. That's a good place to be with your weight and your rep ratio. All right. All right. Ready to finish this one up? We'll move on to the next. All right, here we go. All about the hamstrings here, so feel them stretch. I'm going to use this door, but I will bring this back for when we do those dips. I'm just going to put it right here. Maybe even a little bit further away. All right. This second set is going to be our back and biceps set. So for my back, I am going to put the band in the door, and I'm going to pull it down. Now, here's the deal. When we design workouts, when we have all the equipment in the world, we like to balance out things that are push and things that are pull. So think about what we just did. This was a push, right? And then this motion is a pull motion, but we don't have cables or anything to resist the pull, right? So when you do upper body, you think about both push and pull, and when you think about back, you think about push and pull. And so I am going to pull today
on the band, right? So I'm gonna put it in the door and I'm gonna pull it down. I'll show you how I'm doing that. Now, if you don't have that band, which I realize most of you don't, I want you to do a row, right? So think about me doing this motion. I want you to also do this motion, but it's a pull motion, right? All right, so that's what I'd like you to do. You're either hinged and you're gonna pull, or you can come down into a plank and renegade row, right? You can come down in the plank and row that way. Now, I'm gonna do one arm at a time, yeah? And I'm gonna do 12 on one side and 12 on the other. And you can do it the exact same way in any position, a row with some kind of dumbbell. All right, and then we're gonna add to that the bicep curls, right? I'm gonna do 12. I probably will end up doing them at the same time, but you can also single arm those if you want. And then we are going to, what are we doing? I'm gonna sit, actually I need the chair. I'm gonna sit and I'm gonna put my mini band on and I'm gonna abduct. And then we're gonna do that a few different ways for our lower body component, to give your back and biceps a little chance to rest. Let me put this back over here. Okay, I'm actually gonna put it against the wall like this so that I can lean into it. I'm gonna use it as a bench, right? And I'm gonna lean forward and abduct. I'm gonna sit up and abduct. And I'm gonna lean back and abduct 12 each way. We're still doing 12 right there. All right, so let me show you how I put this in the door. So first of all, you're gonna tie this in a little bit of a knot. Now, this band is a little bit thick than ones that I've had in the past. This one came off Amazon. Let me see if I can find a brand for you. It seems okay. It's whatever, WOD Fitness, which stands for Workout of the Day. So it's like a CrossFit type brand. Anyway, it seems okay. I've had ones that seem like they would last longer than this, but if you're just like starting out, I've noticed that the brands that I would normally buy are completely sold out, but this one was in stock. All right, so I'm gonna tie it like this. I'm gonna put the knot on the other side of the door. All right, and I'm gonna place this one pretty high. All right, then you're gonna pull on it to make sure it's okay. And for me on this one, I am going to kneel, and I'm gonna pull it like this, pull it down, and I want it to my arm to be able to go all the way back up. So I'm gonna be like this. And I'm gonna pull down thusly. So then you are going to maybe be rowing, right? All right, so those are our activities, right? I'm gonna pull 12 on one side. I'm gonna pull 12 on the other side. I'm gonna bicep curl for 12. And then I'm gonna throw this band on. And I'm gonna 12 three ways. We're doing three sets of it. You ready? All right, let me put this on here. Ready to go? All right. The pull-up bar, I decided I would buy myself a little bit more fitness equipment. So I bought like a hip thrusting bench and a reverse hyper bench. And I decided that I'm gonna clear out my dining room and make it a little temporary gym. So hopefully in the near future when all that comes, we'll make these videos in there. But you know, I know you don't have that equipment, so we'll keep doing ones like this too. All right, you ready? All right. So 12, you get ready with your rows, or if you've got this set up, fantastic. All right, here we go. So I'm keeping my elbow tight to my body. This is a tight row. You're releasing it slow if you have this band. My 12 on this side. I'm gonna come in on this side. Ooh, yeah. I can feel my core working in this, just like you probably do if you're in a plank doing a renegade row, right? More here. Ah, man, it feels good to do things that I haven't done in a few months, something like that. Okay, bicep curls. Now there's 12. I may end up doing a drop set, meaning that like I start with heavier weight and then go.
All right, so 12 on each arm. If I start here, I don't really like to do both arms at the same time. When you go heavy, sometimes you need to do a single arm as to not ruin your back with it, yes? One, three. One arm is harder than the other, yeah? 12 right here. Okay, it wasn't that bad. All right, give your upper body a break, and let's do a little lower body. So if you don't have a band, right, you can always do this abduction standing, right, because that'll give you a little more control over your glutes. I would do it standing if you don't have anything to put around your legs. All right, so each one of these, that's pretty good. I'm trying to determine whether because I'm very short, right? So I would prefer if my knees were like a little higher, I guess, like a couple inches higher. So I'm considering, let me try. Let me pull out my step stool here and see if that's better. It might not be. I just want to feel like I can push my heels into the ground, and because I'm so short, sometimes I can't do that. That's worse. Is it worse? Yeah, it's worse. Okay. So, leaning forward, like way forward, sitting straight up, and then leaning back. You can hold on to this, right? Each one of those works it in a slightly different way. 12 each way. Here we go. We might go two times through. Let's see how we feel. One. So I'm rolling the insides of my feet up. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Stop for a second. Sit up. Straight up. 9, 10, 11, 12. And then lean back. Leaning back used to be the hardest one for me. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Do we want to do a second set? Why not? We might give that up in later round. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's like the walls are caving in. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if you're standing, just give different degrees of leaning forward, right? Lean way, lean kind of, and then mostly upright, yeah? 5, 7. Oh, yeah. Whoa. All over the place. All right, we ready for round 2? Look at that. All right, let's do it. Here we go. Resistance both ways when you're using a band like this, right? Because yes, you have to pull it in, but there's also resistance when you let it kind of go back. One more for me. Bicep curls. bicep curls. It's like I feel that on my back, it's warm, right? But it's a different sensation than, you know, for example, the bicep curls where you feel it hard and you feel it immediately, right? It's a warm burn. I feel it kind of up here and down on my lat. All right, let's go. Unlock those knees. Six here. Halfway in. Oh, I see that got slower. Nine. And 11. Ooh. All right. Okay. Let's go. Transition right here can be pretty quick because it's not remotely the same muscle group. Can take a couple breaths. All right. You ready? All right, let's lean forward. Here we go. I'm spreading my feet out so that the band is slightly stretched before I start. Straight up. Pause for a second. Let's go one more time through. Alright. Ready? Alright, lean it in. Let's go. Hold on to it. Oh, convenient. Got that. Three. Take a pause. Sit up straight. One more time through. I'm a little sweaty. I do mean a little, I'm not being sarcastic, like I'm a little sweaty. All right, here we go. Get a nice grip on here. Two more. All right. Let that go. Bicep curl. All right, here we go. Whoa. Three. Okay. this. Come on. Ah. There we go. All right. For a second, let it all kind of be that wave of just like, I don't even know, kind of pain, kind of just tightness come through. And we'll go through one more time. One more little section here. So this one is going to be chest and triceps, and then we're going to add some glutes. So chest push-ups perhaps is where you're at. You can always chest fly if you prefer. And then for your triceps, we're going to do the dips. And then for your glutes, you've got a couple options now. If you miraculously have the band, I'll show you what to do. If not, you're gonna kettlebell swing. So you're gonna reach those dumbbells up and squeeze it. You'll see why, because the band move that I'm going to do is very similar to a kettlebell swing, except with a band, it basically takes the cardio lower on it, and you can intensify the squeeze on your own. So I'm gonna move my band from where it is down, but I do wanna show you one thing you can do with this band. While it's up here, right? So you can use this band for things like this, right? So I'm pulling it apart and getting my upper back, right? You can do it like this and bring it down, right? So once you have something like this, it's useful for a lot of different things. I'm gonna move it down and I'm essentially gonna pull it through my legs. So I'm gonna open my door. Bring it pretty low. You have to have a pretty sturdy door, right? This may not work if you've got like a hollow core bedroom door. This happens to be my door into the garage. So it's one of my more intense doors. And you definitely need something like that because you don't want to pull the door out of the latch in the middle of an exercise. All right, so what I'm gonna do with this time is clear this guy out of the way. And I'm gonna come out like this. Now you have to walk decently far. Now, this is something you can do with a cable machine at the gym, right? You've got the handlebar cable attachment. You roll the cable thing down low. And you're gonna start completely parallel to the floor. And then you're gonna come up and pull, right? Pull it up. And with that, you're gonna give me the biggest squeeze, just like you would in a kettlebell swing. So it's gonna be here and here. And since I'm doing it this way, I'm gonna hold each squeeze, which you can't really do in a kettlebell swing. I'm gonna hold each one to get that contraction and hold it for, you know, basically what's gonna end up being like a full second or something like that. If you're kettlebell swinging, stay with the momentum, all right? All right, so we've got it. We've got push-ups, we've got the tricep dips, and then we've got either the pull-throughs or the kettlebell swings. All right, so let's see. Maybe I'll move this guy over here a little. Dip off that way. All right. I might actually chest fly today in lieu of push-ups. I'm just not feeling it today. All right. All right, let's go. You know, in a perfect world, I would push-up because it incorporates more muscles. I'm really trying to conserve energy for my Friday, Saturday, Monday run of tough exercises out in the heat, right? So I want to be a little bit mindful of that. All right, so I'm going to start chest. I'm going to go dips, then I'm going to go pull-throughs. All right. As many of you know, after I had my enhancements done, my chest has never been the same. It's always very tight and it's very weak in a way. So my push-ups are not really good, but also I go pretty light on my chest. All right, we're going 12. Here we go. I definitely feel it. It's probably also because we've done a lot of upper body. I've got two more. For example, a normal pull-up now, it kind of zings underneath, which is what I feel sometimes when I do chest activities. And then I just have to modify, I just have to change. Like, I can't bench press anymore. It just feels really weird. And so I might modify actually that to a chest press the next time I go down, because I'm feeling the little zing start, and I don't think that's necessarily a good thing. All right, you can always replace these dips with the kickbacks that we did in the warm-up. That's why we did those. All right, the further you stick out your feet, the harder it's going to be. You can always add something to your lap. Normally at the gym I would do 20 of these. Let me see how I feel after 12. I think I might go to 15. All right, I'm gonna take a sip of water. We got that whole thing two more times through. Let's see how we're doing on the time today. Oh, it's a long one. Chest press. If I go chest press, I'm going to go a little heavier on the dumbbells. If you take any of those options, the push-ups, the flies, you can come with me and press if you want. Alright, we've got 12. Here we go. So I'm going to tap my elbows on the floor to get a full range of motion. How's your upper body feeling? I definitely feel like this workout has been focused on that. I can feel it, but my legs feel like I'm working them, but they're not dying, which is an excellent way for me to go into tomorrow, right? All right. Here we go. Taking a moment. It's okay to take a moment. Everything's burning now. Everything up here. All right. Ready, let's go. Feeling it on one cheek more than the other. So now I'm trying to concentrate on that one cheek, yeah? There we go. Going to 15 again. All right, one more time through. We're already at a minute three, but remember I talked for like 4 minutes, so. Ready? Get her done? All right. We're just gonna stretch out after this round is done. Blah, blah, blah. All right, here we go. One more. To see chest be done. It's like one of my least favorites, I think, because, you know, I can't do a lot, but also it's just very tight all the time. All right. All right. Get these done. So you're going pretty low, right? But not so low that the torque on your shoulder is too much. All right, you ready? Get these done. 12. Whoa. Start a new music. How about Pop Funk 6? All right. One more thing to do. Look back in slowly into it. All right. Here we go. Parallel. Kettlebell swing. You ready? Let's go. Didn't hold that one very long. More. That was me going to 15. High five. Ooh, all right. Maybe I'll use my chair to stretch out today. I'm gonna put it on this mat. I'm just gonna my floor is slippery. All right. So, I'm going to reach on the back. And first of all, stretch my back. Now lean my hips side to side. I'm gonna pull this in and push it back out. Trying to sink my chest and pull my shoulders up. So like shoulders up, chest down. All right, let's take our leg across like a pigeon, right? On the chair. I'm gonna sink this leg a little bit. Come back up, put a little force into this. Kind of leaning side to side on this. Reach across this way, lean away, see if we can open this lat. I'm leaning my whole body away from this arm. Do the same thing on the other side. All right, come in for that other side of the pigeon. My leg that hurts. This is my leg that's very tight. I'm gonna drop this leg down a little bit. Push my knee down a little. And back into it. Alright, push back here. I'm gonna take my foot on top, come down. I'm gonna rotate my toes, right? Side to side. Same thing on the other side. So tight, this whole leg. It's interesting, you can do the same workout, right? Spread out, and it affects your body totally differently than doing it, you know, close together. And some of that's just a factor of age. Like, as we age, we just don't recover as fast. All right, I'm gonna use the wall for a couple stretches. And then I'm going to come down on the mat and do the stretches that I need to kind of get this leg back in shape. So you can stay with me or you can go at this point. I know it's been a long one. So I'm going to reach behind me. I'm going to stretch my chest out. Same thing on the other side. I'm gonna come back to that. I'm gonna put my heels up against the wall. I'm gonna stretch this up and down. I'm gonna take one arm across. All right, back this to this one more time. Ooh, yeah. Other side. All right, so the stretch that I need to do for me, right, because it is where it's starts is here, and for me, then it wraps around, and when it gets really bad, it goes down, and then when it gets really, really bad, it goes down into here, and that's where I'm at, right? It's like in its full force. Usually, like as I, you know, if I can get some regular massages, if I can, if I'm good about doing my stretches, right, it comes out of here and then rewinds basically back through. And you can't really feel tightness in your hip flexors. It doesn't ache like other places, but I would just assume if you're a modern human that your hip flexors are tight, right? So a lot of this comes from stretching out hip flexors, and my hip flexors happen to be, this leg happens to be tight like that, right?
So, and I've learned that through going to various professionals, right? So I'm gonna do this stretch, you've seen me do it before, but out of all the stretches, this is my biggest pain relief for me, this, and preventative. So I'm just gonna hang out here. I might even foam roll a little bit. Just keep the camera rolling, but feel free to turn me off at any point. Oh, so like for me, it's like right here, and then I can feel it stretching down, right? But if it releases that around the back side, then my pain that comes along the outside will stop, or at least lessen. But I definitely need some manual therapy. It's been months since I've gotten that, so. So this is my side that probably is tight but doesn't hurt as much, right? Sometimes when you have a side that hurts a lot, you won't feel the pain in the other side. So it is tight, I'm sure it's tight, right? But I don't feel it as much. So, but I'm still gonna stretch this side out. This really is a stretch you need to do more than once in a sitting, because you'll kind of get it open and then you'll do some deeper stretching when you go into it a second or a third time. So I'm gonna go back to the other side. Feeling like it relaxed a little bit. I don't think I'm gonna get it to fully loosen today. It's kind of like past the point of no return.
All right, so I'm gonna do a little foam rolling at this point. You're welcome to stay with me, or feel free to turn me off and I'll see you next time. I have this one, and I have one upstairs that has spikes on it. I'm just going to go with this one today because I want to use it also on my back, and the spiky one doesn't feel good on my back, but the spiky one does feel good for my leg. I can bring that down and show you another time. So I'm going to start, this calf is kind of one of the last things that's starting to hurt, like after I am really tight, so I'm going to start on my calves here. I'm going to do them both at the same time, but feel free to sit right and do one at a time, but I'm gonna do them both. This is one of the things that really gets it from all the jumping. And one of the places that you really can't feel it unless you get in there is right down here, right? Those little areas hurt a lot, especially jumping. So I'm gonna turn my feet both the same way so it's getting the sides here. And I'm really just doing both for efficiency's sake, right? You probably, if you have a lot of time, I would concentrate on one at a time. Doing the other way. I'll go into it like this. If you find any knots, right, the deal with the foam rollers, that you're supposed to stay on, so say I found a knot right there, it's pretty easy for me to find a knot. You're going to stay on that knot for like 30 seconds. Put as much pressure as you can on it, and then the knot should at least somewhat release. All right. I'm going to move from there to my glutes. I'm going to go all the way up, and then I'm going to come finish off the leg in between. So the glutes, I'm leaning
on this one glute, right? I'm gonna roll the whole thing from top to bottom first. And I know I'll find knots in there. A lot of mine are kind of at the bottom, right? I'm gonna try to get on them. Roll the whole thing first. Very tight up here. Okay. So I'm gonna sit on this, right? Find it. There it is. I'm gonna sit on that for a second. And you just kind of sit and let it try to relax. Yeah. All right. I'm gonna finish this leg by rolling the hamstring here. I'm gonna get on it. I've got this leg for stability, but I've got all my weight on this. This is one of those that feels good with my spiky roller. I found a knot right there. I'm gonna sit on it. Okay, you can even feel it relax, right? And that way you can turn into it more. Sit on that for a second. Alright, let's see if I can just sit up a little bit, put some pressure on this, see what's in there. I may not have anything on this side that's as bad as this side is. That's the side. Stay on things that you need to stay on, right? Our bodies are gonna have different places that need a little more attention, so. So I am not a big fan of rolling your IT band. In my experience with me, it has recoiled on me. So like if I put pressure, I know this part hurts on a lot of people, but for me, I've made it worse, right? And that's what IT bands tend to do, right? And so if this hurts on you, what I suggest is foam rolling on one side of it and foam rolling on the other side of it. And that will allow it to loosen up. But if you go directly at it, right, it's not like a muscle, right? And it will sometimes get tighter and feel worse. So just be really careful. And it connects down here, right? So if this is a hurtful spot for you, try around that. See if you can loosen it up that way. But if you're somebody who can take it on your IT band, you know, by all means, I am not one of those people. So in that vein, I'm gonna not do that, and I'm gonna come over into my quads, yeah? So you know I've got a quad that's not in good shape, so it's on that same leg. So I'm gonna do both of them at the same time to begin, and then I'm gonna go after both of them individually too. So I'm gonna roll them all the way. And as I'm doing this, I can feel all the places that are very tight. And on my one leg, it's, of course, more team rolling tight than the other. So I'm going to stop right here because both of them have a little kind of painful spot right here. I'm just going to stay on it. And you kind of just stay on it until the pain that you're feeling fades.
right? Because your body is rushing blood to it. It's, you know, trying to loosen it up. And you should eventually feel some kind of release. About a maximum 20, 30 seconds. It shouldn't take longer than that. It might not be a complete release to zero, but the pain that you felt when you started on it will be much less. So I just moved down to another spot. So when I'm very quad dominant, so whenever I do an exercise, my quads like to take over. And so for me, when I go do massages sometimes, right, we they need to spend a lot of time on my quads. They get very knotted, they get very sort of tender. Now I'm just kind of inching my way up. Oh, it's so painful. All right, I'm gonna go after my good quad first, right? And now I'm gonna try to sort of get, you know, quad is four muscles, right? So I'm gonna try to go like in little sections, right? So I'm getting like all sides of that area. So I'm gonna go the outside first, which hurts. Oh man. Pretty good knots in there. You gotta pick your poison, right? You can't go all after them all at the same time. Alright, I'm gonna try the inside. That's not nearly as bad. Alright, so maybe I'll concentrate on the outside a little bit. Oh. Right above my knee there. Oh, yeah. That's huge right there. So I'm gonna stay. See if I get that to relax and try to let my toe go. Oh. There we go. I can feel it. It's almost like a feeling of like the blood can get through. I don't know how to describe it. Alright, come up off that one. And I'm gonna try to do this one. Now this is my painful one, so if I make a bunch of weird noises. Hurts. So bad at the top. I mean, it hurts, but I know it looks like I'm doing nothing yet. Like, I can barely talk. It takes so much. Caused by using this quad, right? This is caused by the misalignment of this leg coming from my hip flexor, right? But it's causing my quad to be used and dominant in ways that it shouldn't, right? It's taking over for the bad position of this leg. And sometimes, right, you can't tell where that misalignment's coming from, which is where you need some, you know, professional assistance. That's, you know, very typical at the connection points of things in your upper body too, where things connect together in an intersection, it tends to be more painful. Oh. I don't want to do too much and, you know, make it worse. So I'm going to roll the whole thing on this side. Kind of move everything around. It feels better than it did when I started. That's good. And I think I'm going to go back and just do both of my quads together one more time. It's better. It's not, you know, not great. All right. I don't know if it's going to get great. all right. So now I'm going to take this on my back. And I'm going to start here. Cross my arms. I'm just going to roll the whole thing just like I was just doing on my legs. Right? Get it kind of primed. You can reach overhead. That upper back should feel very good. Alright, I'm going to stop on this lower back right here. I'm going to kind of lean to one side. The other side. Alright, and I'm going to do a little series of bends here. So I'm going to start with the roller pretty far up. I'm going to reach overhead. I'm going to put my head on the ground, right? And that's like a supported back bend. And it's going to kind of get my upper back, too. So I'm going to lean side to side on this roller. Let me roll my upper back a little bit. See if I can get it to release before I do that. Opening my elbows. All right. So I'm going to stop here and back bend. And the same idea here, right? Leave it here for a few seconds, see if you can get that upper back to release a little bit. And then gradually I'm gonna scoot it down a little bit more, so maybe like an inch and a half at a time. It's gonna feel very different. It's not gonna look that different. Just go until it feels uncomfortable for you to do that move, right? So I probably have one more placement. Feels good on all the things we just worked. All right. I'm going to put it the other direction, vertical. Now, this would be nice if we had a really long one, but I don't, right? So I'm going to get up then in a bridge here, and I'm going to put my head on it if you can, right? And I'm going to let my elbows fall open and onto the floor. I'm going to reach overhead. And you're going to try to keep as much of your arm on the ground as you do this snow angel. I'm running into the wall here, but as much of your arms as you can. And you can always pull these elbows down this way, just like we were doing an overhead press. That opens your chest right here. I'm going to roll slightly to one side and leave this arm out, so I'm leaving this arm long, and it's just like that stretch we did against the wall, right? Stretches that chest, other side. Alright, I'm going to come out of that. I'm going to put my head on it. This video is going to be like 3 hours by the time we're done. All right, and I'm just gonna look side to side. And that's gonna roll out some of your neck. And I definitely have some tension on this side. So I'm gonna look away, and I'm gonna kind of leave it on there, just like you would any other place. All
the spine. I'm pulling my shoulders down. They're kind of releasing as my neck releases. I'm able to sort of drop my shoulders more. And I'm going to stay mostly on that side because this is the side I can tell is very tense, even up here, like under my ear. I'm going to stay over here, even though I'm not looking at you. I could just stay like this. Should we be done? Give me a like little drink. It's almost like I'm on a pool floaty, except I'm in my living room working out. All right. That was a long one. What are we at?
1:30. Hour and a half. We did it though. Have a good day.